Okay, in a real rush around here today because I want to get this thing finished. I have a show day after tomorrow in Tulsa. And although this is sold already, I hope, I still want to take it down there and show it. Okay? So what I've done, I've got my shield here. I put a lighter color of paint here. And how I did that, let me take it off here. How I did that is I painted it with a real light tan. Then I used raw sienna on the outside here and blended it back into the tan. And then I used some white and blended the white out into the both of the other colors. I've drawn on my design. Person who's interested in this like buffalo. So I've put a skull on here plus some other decorations. There's three hooves up here. Now I've made three little feathers. They will go down here on the bottom. These are owl feathers. These will go down here on the bottom like that. There's an owl feather here. There are lots of those around here. And right now, I'll set that aside. Right now I'm in the process of making some earrings for him. Now, how do I make earrings? Okay. First, using some copper wire, just Judy will scoot back here. It's just house wire. You know, that I've got left over from other projects. I'll just strip it out and take out the center wire, or one of the three wires, and strip off the insulation and buff the wire up to where it's shiny and looks good. The thing's back here. With a pair of needle-nose pliers, I bend it around like this right here, and that will allow me to just slip the earring right on there like that. This little wire here, I bent out of a piece of 18 gauge wire. You can get that down Walmart, okay? And that will go after I apply a little bit of super glue. That will go right in here. And the reason why I leave it open like that is when I slide that in there, that's going to go underneath his ear like that.
Turn it the other way.
Which way?
I can't see that it went underneath the ear.
It will go underneath that ear and look like and complete the circle. Understand? You'll be able to see it here a little better on the other side. And I'm just going to leave that dangling. I like things that dangle. Okay, here's the other one for the other side. It's all ready to go. Get my little solder joint over on the other side. And that's the dull side of my... And so let me get that around here. Like that. And that will go right in there. And that one's going to have to be sanded a little on that point. Sorry for the confusion. I really do know what I'm doing. So I'll take this over to my little sander here.
Hold on.
And I'm just going to sand that point off that was on there because I nipped it off, okay? That should do it. Now we'll go back over to the workbench. Slip it on there again. And just slide it in there. I see a problem. this little side here. See, it's bent over, so I need to bend it back the other direction. Not like that, should that. Hope. Put that back on there. There. Looks pretty spiffy. Looks good. Okay, now what? Oh yeah, I wanted to tell you what I did. Okay. The base is finished. I got my name. This is Long Robe. I varnished it with some Minwax satin finish varnish. Really put it on thick and allowed it to soak in, and then took a paper towel. Don't use, if you do this, don't use anything other than a paper towel to come back after you wash your brush and kind of just wipe off the shiny areas. There won't be that many. And then after that, haven't bought this before, go down to Hobby Lobby and buy you a couple cans of this stuff. You'll find it over in the model section. It costs $5. It's a lacquer. Alright, it's a lacquer, and we varnish this with a mineral-based varnish. Those two things don't mix. So when you use this, you want to make sure this is completely dry, or it's going to flash on you, just turn white. Your oak carving will just turn white, and you don't want that. But what this will do, this will kill the shine. I've already sprayed this. But when you spray it, what you want to do, let me show you here. What you want to do is you don't want to hold there and spray it all down soaking wet. Like the beading here is kind of got a sheen to it. That's okay. It's glass beading, so it's all right. But what you want to do is, you want to do this on the back, okay?
There.
You can see the little crosses I added. They really made a difference. And you can also see how shiny that is. And I can see a little tag on there. Don't want that. Just want to do this. That's all you need to do. And that stuff will dry real quick, and it might not kill the shine completely, but it's going to take away most of it. Like these here were really shiny because I put a lot of paint on these, and you can see it turned it into a real nice little satin finish, okay? And then I glued the carving to the base with a dowel,
like a silver,
quarter inch dowel, and some epoxy. Okay, so he's, if you wanted a Indian bust without a shield, there it is. But the shield, once we get the shield on there and painted, it's going to look really good. Now, making these earrings, I'm going to show you how I do that. Judy will follow me over to another spot. Guys, girls may have taken a shop in the old days. I don't know if they even have it in schools now. I sort of doubt it. But anyway, metal shop, you learn to make all sorts of things. This is a continuation of your metal shop education. With a ball peen hammer and a piece of aluminum ducting, you can buy this down at Lowe's or Home Depot or a hardware shop. It's real thin sheets of aluminum they use for ducting up on the roof and heating and air conditioning, everything. It's easy to find. I'm just going to take this and I'm going to beat it. And that's what you get. You see the shine, the texture on there? Back over to the other workstation. And this stuff is so thin, you can just cut it with a pair of scissors. You know, I always use my wife's sewing scissors. They're the best ones around here. And just cut it to the shape you want it. We're just experimenting here, so I'll just make a small one just for fun of it. Okay, that's not perfect, but it's close enough. I'd go ahead and round that off a little prettier over on my sander. All right, I take my awl, find a hole here. Set it right there. Just give it a little whack, like that, to make the hole for the wire that's going to be added. In a little bit. That makes a nice little hole. Now I'll take this over to the sander and sand off this torn stuff, and then just round this top here to make it look nice. And then after you bend your little eyelet up here with the wire, and use this little wire here to just take a second, just grab it down here and just bend it around. Somebody's not happy out there. Then with a pair of wire nippers, get them there. Circle, but it'll work for a demonstration. You just slide your earring in there like that. And again, this is just demonstration, so forgive me if this is oblong. So line everything up again, and I always solder that joint, and that will slip right into your little wire ring that's holding it, and look real nice. Doesn't take long, but little details like this, I tell you, that is the secret when you're working on things. Okay, now we're all over. Anyway, got those on there. After I painted this, before I put my pencil drawing on there, I went ahead and sealed it with some spray, matte finish spray you can get down at Walmart. Because when I draw my drawing on here, I want to be able to erase it off of there. And if it was just bare wood, drawing on a piece of wood with pencil, you're never going to get rid of all of it. But doing it this way, you'll be able to get rid of your pencil drawing. I've marked me three spots here to where I'm going to tie these feathers to it. They also need to be varnished yet. So right now what we're going to do is we're going to go and start painting our design.
Okay, you see the design?
Kind of. Yeah. All right, I found this. This on the internet. I think I'm going to go with something like that.
but then I'm going to change it quite a bit by incorporating other designs from other shields that I have in my little reference book there. So first off, what we're going to do is paint the buffalo, okay? So I've got me a green paint here that pretty well matches that. Probably going to take a couple coats. Green paint. I'll dry that. This is yellow ochre, and what I've done is I'm underpainting this color on. And then I'll come back over it with the brighter yellow. This green is pretty opaque, so I don't need to do that with the green. again. I don't know how much of this you want to watch. I think Judy's the one who's paying for this. She has to hold that camera. Take a couple of holds of that too. Putting this on pretty thick. Dry that. From a guy that's interested in this carving, wondering when in the hell is it going to be over. Well, when it gets done. Dry this and let Judy take a break.
Okay.
All right, now I'm painting his horns. Which are just black. have to outline the outline this go. Carefully. Stick my brush in that cream. That's dry. Now you can't really see much in this picture here, but they're the plates of the buffalo skull. There's a mark here, mark there. Here's the nose plate here. Comes down, goes back up. I'm going to try to draw those in here. Thank you. it's enough. Now I'm going to find me a blue here. That'll have to be double coated. Or triple coated, whatever it takes to. Color on there. All I can say is whoever gets this ending's getting a nice one. We can say. Good. Put that away. Now I'm going with my red iron oxide. I'm going to paint some lines here. Yeah, what's some Barrett number? Where'd you go? Just a minute ago. Buffalo hoof prints up here. I say, always wash your hands, let things dry. Well, it's just going to have to wait till I get this up. This would be the one, you know, there's always one. that dry. Clean up my stick. This is just a piece of 1/8 inch dowel, carving off all the old paint here. We're going to start with spots on here. Oh, I got paint everywhere. What the hell? I'm gonna go wash my hands.
Okay, here goes. One side done. Where's my green? I still got lots of green here, so I'm just gonna use it.
Green or green?
No, sorry, yeah, it's lots of yellow. I don't know if the yellow itself will be strong enough. Yellow spots are bigger than the red ones. I have to do something about that. To the crunch here, and that's when things happen. Okay. I got one thing. Thank you. almost there. Let my air out. Okay, I'm going to set that out in the sun after I touch up my goofs. I'll just hold this up here for a sneak peek. It looks pretty good once we get those feathers hanging down there. So again, I'm going to touch that up, take it out the sun, let it completely dry, come back, erase all my pencil marks, and then give it a coat of varnish and glue it in place, and it will be done. So that's going to end this video project. I hope you've enjoyed coming along with me. When I varnish the shield, all those colors will become a lot darker. And I'll put a photograph on my blog of it once it's completely finished. So, that's going to do it for this project. And until the next one comes along, I'll talk to you later.